Welcome back, guys. Chris here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about how to apply a credit to a transaction in NetSuite. And I'm not just going to be talking about things from an order to cash standpoint, we're also going to be looking at it from a procure to pay standpoint. So before we dive into it, let's just make sure we understand the circumstances. First, we're going to start with order to cash, and the basic flow for order to cash, or you could say the generic flow, is sales order, item fulfillment, invoice, and customer payment. And it's really the last part of that flow where credit memos come into play. When you're in the invoice or payment stage, you can then have a credit memo, a return, a refund, et cetera. That can all come off of that last portion of the flow. So that's the basic concept. Now let's make a specific example. Let's say we as a company have a customer, let's say ABC customer, and ABC customer has purchased in the past, let's say 5 widgets from us. So they bought the widgets, we then ship them the widgets, and either they were dissatisfied and they returned the widgets to us, or maybe there was something that was flawed with them. So we provided, for whatever reason, we provided that customer with a credit memo for some amount. Okay, so that's the circumstance, and that has occurred in the past. So this customer already has a credit memo on account. And if you don't know how credit memos and returns work, I have other videos specifically on that that I cover in my accountant's course. So you can definitely check that out if you want. But for the sake of this video, we're assuming that customer has had a transaction in the past, they have credit on account, and now, let's say 2 months have passed, they're now trying to buy something from us newly, and they want to apply that credit that they have on account to this new purchase. So that's the circumstance, and let's see how this works in NetSuite. All right, so here we are in NetSuite, and I'm gonna come up here. I actually have an invoice already pulled up here. So in this case, the customer is Ultima Technology, and you can see this is an invoice. This is the new invoice, not the old one. This is the new transaction that we've got going where they're trying to buy from us. If I scroll down here, it looks like they're buying some battery packs, 4 in total. And so it's going to be about $400 for those battery packs. So that is this invoice transaction. And what we want to do is, or what the customer really wants to do is, the customer wants to, when it has to then pay for these batteries, it wants to take that old credit memo and apply it to this transaction. So there's actually a few ways that you can do this, but there's two I want to point out that are simple ways to apply that credit memo to this particular transaction. And the first method is if we go straight from this invoice, remember that process flow, invoice goes to customer payment. So we're going to push this invoice forward to that customer payment record. And we're going to do that by coming over here to accept payment. So if I click on that, it keeps that invoice record. That doesn't disappear, but it's going to now spawn off of that a customer payment record that would then need to be saved. So we have this new customer payment record. It fills in all that information. You can see on the right here, it's for about $400 with Ultima Technology. And if we scroll down here, this is where we can actually start applying these credit memos. So you can see here under apply as its subtab, under sublist invoices, you can see we've got this transaction. Now, if this customer had maybe 9 outstanding invoices with us, we would see them all listed out here, and they could do one payment at the same time. They could consolidate all those invoices together as one payment. But in this particular case, we've just got one invoice and we want to apply an old credit memo to this invoice. So what we're going to do is we're going to come here to the sublist credits. And by clicking on that, you can see we've got this old credit memo here. And this credit memo is for $475. So that's from the old transaction. They had that credit on account. And all we have to do to apply that credit memo to this new transaction is to come over here and hit apply. As soon as we do that, notice it does a couple things. First off, now this number went from 0. Now something is being applied. So it fills in the amount there and it fills it over on the right. And you can see this is the full amount being applied. So there's not going to be any payment needed on this transaction. It won't even end up using the full credit memo because it can only apply $397 out of the full $475. We could even say that we don't want to apply the full credit memo. Let's say, depending on whatever the circumstances, our company policy, you can't apply a full credit memo to any one transaction. Maybe you can only apply 25% of it. So maybe they can only come in here and apply $100 of that old credit memo to this new transaction. So they'll have to piece it out over several transactions to be able to use up that full credit. Well, whatever the circumstance is, you have some flexibility there. So that's one way that you could apply this credit memo. From here, all we'd have to do is come over here and hit save, and we would have applied that. But there is that second method I was mentioning. So now we're gonna actually go to the credit memo itself. Now I could click down here on this credit memo, but I've already got it pulled up here. So I'll click on this, and you can see this is a credit memo again with Altima Technology. And we're gonna scroll over here on the side, and this is where we can see, in this case, this is a credit memo, as we saw before, for $475. So that is the total for this credit memo. We can even come down here and say what this came from. So this was a credit memo from an old transaction where they had purchased VGA cables, and that ended up being for $474. So that is what it's for, but we wanna now apply this to the new transaction. Again, this is the second method. So we can come over here to apply. And again, if the customer had 15 different invoices, we'd see them all listed out here. We could decide where this credit memo is going. In this case, there's only one. So we come down here, we hit apply. Once again, on the right here, we can dictate how much of this credit memo is gonna be applied to this one transaction. After that, we're good to go. We can hit save, and it immediately updates that credit memo showing what has been applied, what was the original amount, what has been applied, and what is left standing. You can see all that information down here. You can come down here to apply, see what's been done in the past. So that's on the order to cash side, how you can take an existing credit memo, apply it to an invoice. Now let's take a look at the procure to pay side of things, which is almost identical, right? Procure to pay is really just a mirror image of order to cash. Instead of sales order, item fulfillment, invoice payment, it goes purchase order, item receipt, bill, and then bill payment. So same circumstance. In this case, this is obviously, we're now on the other end of the spectrum. We've bought something. We were given a vendor credit, also known as a bill credit. So we have, in this case, this is the new bill. We're trying to now buy something newly from, in this case, our vendor is Acme Company. So this is a new transaction, and we want to take an old vendor credit and apply it to this transaction. So again, there's several ways to do it, but there's two in particular I want to point out. One is pushing forward this bill to be a bill payment. So we'll click make payment. It'll bring us to that new payment record that we're creating, and we can simply go down and apply that outstanding credit. So you can see I'm here on a bill payment. I scroll down, we've got apply, and then right here. Now, in this case, we don't have to jump between sublists. It actually shows us everything in one place, which is pretty convenient. So you can see not only the bill here, as well as any other bills that were outstanding with this vendor. And then, of course, the credit appears right there. So we can hit apply on this. In this case, this was a very large bill credit for $2,000, and we can apply a portion of that to this existing one. So we have that now selected here. And of course, I could also come to the bill credit itself by clicking on the hyperlink here. I have that open here. So this is the older bill credit for $2,000 that we're looking at here. And I can come down here under items. It was originally a credit for expenses, but I can come over here to apply. And it gives me the option to see this new bill that is outstanding, and I can apply it right here. I hit save. It's now applied that vendor credit, also known as a bill credit, to that new transaction. And that's a quick run through of how to apply credits to transactions in NetSuite. If you want to dive deeper into the whole world of returns, return authorizations, refunds, all of that, it can get significantly more complicated. And I cover that in much greater detail in my accountant's course. But for now, you understand the basic concept of how you take an existing credit and apply it to a new transaction. So with that in mind, I'll see you in the next video.